More news, a technology solutions provider seeks to develop a data repository for the country's healthcare system. Advanced Abilities inked a partnership with U.S.-based technology firm HeyPass to centralize healthcare records using secure technology. Now, AAS plans to introduce a sovereign cloud to keep sensitive data within the country's jurisdiction. Artificial intelligence and quad-sec encryption will help prevent record duplication, while AI-driven analytics aim to improve patient care and expand healthcare access to remote areas.
It's more secured in access, and also it's better to have one single record of each person in the Philippines, because eventually you will have one golden record for each Filipino citizen for health. Because right now everybody's holding different type of record. So this will be a repository for historical record from when you're born all the way up to the end of life. And it will be the main record keeping for every Filipino.
Social security institutions across Asia are exploring the possibility of co-investing in regional projects. Representatives are currently in Manila to discuss potential future collaboration. Jackie Pascual has details.
The Philippines may tap foreign investments not only from private firms, but also from the pension fund of other countries. The country is hosting the ASEAN Social Security Association meetings, where delegates from social security institutions from Southeast Asia are in attendance. They say they collectively manage $1.3 trillion in assets, which can have an impact on regional development.
How we allocate capital as investors also has impact on our respective real economies. So that is a good example, I think, of collaboration.
We collectively hold a very huge amount of funds that we're supposed to let grow for the benefit of our members. And collectively, what we aim is to make safe investments, but at the same time, not only help our respective nations, but help the rest of ASEAN.
Veloso says there is a possibility for social security institutions to co-invest in ASEAN projects and for other foreign pension funds to invest in the Philippines as well.
Ability for all of these long-term fund managers also, now that they're in the Philippines, to understand the key needs of our country, to bring the cost of power down, to have infrastructure be available, food security, you need the healthcare, you need the educational facilities.
They add they aim to assess the risk, appetite, and priorities of each social security institution member so they can see where they can collaborate together.
For power opportunities in the Philippines, there may be the same as energy opportunities in Malaysia. Toll roads in the Philippines can have toll roads in the rest of ASEAN. Food security concerns in the Philippines is a priority and a concern for other countries.
We have great interest in investing in infrastructure all throughout the region. And I think as the world also embarks on this big transition in energy systems, there will be huge, large capital needs that pension funds in particular are well poised to deliver.
The Philippines will hold the chairmanship of ASA starting this week with Veloso as the new chairman. And he says he will begin conversation with each member to foster regional cooperation to push for social protection of millions of people in the region. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippines and Sweden ink a government-to-government agreement for financial and development cooperation, enabling Manila to access grants from Sweden for priority programs. The Memorandum of Understanding also opens the door for technical assistance, concessional development aid, and blended financing from Sweden. Projects set to benefit from this agreement include the EDSA Busway, Subic-Clark-Manila-Batangas Railway, and hybridizing diesel power plants, among others. Now, Finance Secretary Ralph Recto says the partnership will enhance the economic security of Filipinos by boosting access to Swedish financing for sustainable development projects. Over 1 billion pesos worth of coins deposited through the Philippine Central Bank's coin deposit machines as of November 15. The machines have processed more than 280 million coins and facilitated over 255,000 transactions. Launched in June last year, the machines allow customers to deposit coins for credit to their GCash or Maya wallets or convert them into shopping vouchers. This initiative supports the BSP's coin recirculation program, helping to put idle coins back into circulation to meet the country's currency needs. Currently, coin deposit machines are deployed in partner retail establishments across the Greater Manila area. In other news, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. departs for the United Arab Emirates Monday night for a one-day state visit. In Abu Dhabi, he will meet with His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Al Sayed Nahyan, with agreements expected to strengthen bilateral ties. Environment Secretary Maria Antonio Yulo Loizaga also joins Marcos to discuss a deal aimed at preventing plastic waste leakage into the oceans. A cultural cooperation agreement also expected to be signed. While the president is away, Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla, and Agrarian Reform Secretary Conrado Estrella III will serve as caretakers of the country. President Marcos's visit to the Gulf nation comes amid concerns over an alleged assassination threat from Vice President Sara Duterte. The issue has drawn global attention, with business groups voicing concerns about its potential impact on the Philippine economy and investment inflows. A local business group is particularly calling for consistency and stability from the Philippine government. Rene Almendras, president of the Management Association of the Philippines, emphasized the need for the government to reassure both local and international investors that it is business as usual. Almendras also pointed to the uncertainty surrounding the trade policies of U.S. President-elect Donald Trump as another challenge for the business community.
Our competitive as a country is also determined by the image and our reputation as a country. So most important to business is consistency and regularity of policy. I am hoping that that will continue to be and will be emphasized as we go through these politically challenging times.
Local corporate news, former Metro Pacific Tollways President Rogelio Singson reveals he is being considered for a role in the MVP Group's water business. He, however, clarified it is too early to confirm which specific unit or project he will be assigned to or the exact role that he will play. Metro Pacific Investments Corporation's water sector interests include Metro Pacific Water and Maynilad.
I was told the MVP wants me to go to the MPIC group, no? Head office, to do, I think my understanding is water sector. Water sector in MPIC, kasi marami investments ang MPIC sa tubig. It's early days, so in fact, I really don't know yet at this time. Wala pa naman kaming, basta nabanggit lang na ganito after November 21.
A real estate firm sees significant changes in the Philippine market as remote work continues to shape or reshape, in fact, homes and the way they are designed. Now, federal land sees a growing demand in the country for homes that are not only places to live, but also optimized for work-from-home setups. The company vows to align their developments with the evolving needs of the modern homeowner.
Ever since COVID, the market has changed. There is a lot more emphasis on using your home, not just, you know, traditionally as a place to live, but also it's a place to work. We're seeing that in the office market, that, you know, hybrid work has not gone away, you know, despite the fact that the pandemic is a few years behind us now. There is that generation of employees who still, you know, find it very important for them that they have, you know, one or two days work from home. So we're designing homes to allow that to happen and still maintain, you know, the home as what it traditionally is.